Just another day and then I'll hold you tight. If only I can get through this. If only I can get through this. If only I can get through this. God, God, gotta help me get through this. I gotta get through this. I gotta get through this.
Struggling that much?
Someone's having.
We just had some Daniel Bedingfield on.
Other energy drinks are available.
Calf pal.
10 seconds to go.
Well, I think I may have just slipped back in time, ladies and gentlemen. These picks are Radiant's very reminiscent pick of a game that happened not so long ago. You got to ask yourself though: has everyone watched the patch notes? Big changes.
Are there actually changes?
I don't know. I do not know. Let's get on that. Patch notes.
I'm just enjoying my tea right now.
Oh, I'm so jealous of that tea. I'm so jealous.
Looks like it might have a little bit of honey in it as well. Mama Keen looking after me properly.
Let's see. Brewmaster selection after Primal Spirit. All clicking on recipes. All clicking on items.
Pretended that we were going to try and talk about the game.
They were patch note related.
We haven't even done that.
Patch notes.
Okay, guys, so we've seen the kind of expected bans. We've got the Doom ban, the Darkseid ban, the Alchemist ban, Undying, once again banned, and then we move into the expected picks. Slardar, obviously very strong, and Wyvern.
Are you Dazzle talking about meta expected, or like LSE versus Southampton?
They're sticking with the meta pretty closely, right?
If this is clockwork now, I'm walking away.
5 seconds.
I honestly expected Dazzle. Wyvern Dazzle is really strong defensively. Although, based on last game, we did see that they were pretty strong with the aggressive lineup. So maybe they will be looking for a more aggressive support here. I mean, we saw the very unconventional lineup last time with the Clockwork Windrunner off lane, and I did speak to Alex briefly between the games, and he said that his team was actually very unhappy with the lineup before they went into that game.
Who is this again, sorry?
The LSE captain said that his team were very unhappy with their lineup before they went into game 2.
I thought it was a pretty solid lineup, really. I mean, obviously it stomped, didn't it? I mean,
it was fairly unusual, I guess. But we can't deny that it was effective. Whether or not that was the draft or the execution, we do not know. Because
maybe
we have
it was just the peculiarities of it. I mean, how do you counter the crazy?
And this is an extremely strong first two picks from Southampton. I very much expect to see LSE ban Dazzle here because we already have a huge amount of armor manipulation coming out from Southampton with the Slardar ultimate and the Shadow Fiend aura, and they're not going to want to put Weave on top of that.
10 seconds to go. Hmm.
Shadow Fiend is pretty
gankable. That is all the analysis I'm going to do for the whole game.
Really?
Yep. That was too much. I'm shattered. I'm not
Team's
paid enough
for this. I hear you just rolling in Huawei on a 7 phones.
Huawei, yeah. Not even cash, just handsets everywhere.
You're just like going down the local spa, you're like, right, that's £2.50 for that loaf of bread and some milk and a chocolate bar. Like, do you take Huawei phones?
We don't have spas down South Gand.
What?
Once you get to about Birmingham, they stop being spas.
Shut up. Where do you buy all your goodies?
Our garages are like Marks and Spencers and stuff. I'm not even joking. My local garage is a Marks and Spencers garage.
I suppose they've got to like figure out some way of justifying that £5 for like 2 Tic Tacs
and
a paper. Yeah.
I got some mini Tic Tacs from Frankfurt and they're so cute. They're like the cutest Tic Tacs you've ever seen in your life.
Well, my workmate brought home like a giant box of Tic Tacs. Is that what you got from Frankfurt? Like the little packets that come in the giant box?
Yeah, that's exactly what I got. How cute are they?
They are pretty little cushy.
Whoa! We've never advertised so much without me saying other mint type sweets are available.
There's like
if
zero
from
other mints.
If anyone is listening, then please get in touch because I love Tic Tacs.
I genuinely can't think of a single other mint. There's none other. There's only Tic Tacs.
Polos are nice. I really like fruit polos.
Buy Tic Tacs.
Fruit polos are really hard to find. Don't see fruit polos around very much.
Can you imagine the fruit polo Tic Tac combo?
Oh my god. I tell you what, a Tic Tac is probably the perfect size to squeeze into the middle of a polo.
That's what I was thinking. It'd be like a little wheel.
We're onto something there, Gant. You should
Transformer mints.
You're wasted in either
everything.
IT or DoTA.
I'm wasted in everything.
You should be in marketing.
That's right. I just like sit here on a Twitch channel and then like they put something on that they don't want me to advertise and I'll talk about everything else.
Yep. So as I said, if someone from Tic Tac is listening and there's so many viewers that I wouldn't be surprised if someone was, then get in touch. amy@gamebritannia.com and we'll work something out.
Indeed.
We're not demanding people. We will accept very minimal amounts of Tic Tacs. There is the Dazzle Band from LSE. Clearly I do know what I'm talking about.
Indeed, Southampton, again, with like I think that's an identical ban order.
Yep, they definitely do not want to see this Beam Meepo come out. And they're quite worried about the Bounty Hunter. Maybe that is a strong hero for one of the LSE players. Or generally, they're just not a fan of it. Like, we
I
did
thought
see
since it's nerf, it was like not really being picked out as much.
Maybe they really are very keen on the whole Shadowblade Shadow Fiend combo, and they do not want the track ruining that dream. There's a certain mysterious character in chat who really wants to see an Outworld Devourer pick.
I can't see it myself.
I'm inclined to say that he's probably been sniffing a bit too much cocaine, because
reserved
that's not going to happen.
Whoa.
Kenny probably has not actually been sniffing cocaine, for those who were in doubt, but maybe he has. He is, you know, he's away in Boston. I don't know what goes down in Boston.
Boston? Throwing cocaine out the window. Sniffing
it
down.
All the way through to this stage of the picking. Usually he would be banned pretty early, but here he is. And the Tusk Slardar combo is, I don't know, do you want to pick
it's
an adjective?
It's genuinely horrible. Like, genuinely I'm going with horrible.
Not only an adjective, but an adverb as well. Wow.
I'm generous.
Words. It is. It is very horrible. You do not want a Slardar rolling in and crushing you. No one wants that. I tell you who really doesn't want that. Crystal Maiden. The squishiest of squishies.
There's a point where she just wants to live in base and be like, there, you've got your aura. That's what I'm providing.
Aura.
Have it.
You guys take it from here.
Yep, I've done my work.
People in chat are asking themselves, are they still going to be talking about mints in 2 minutes? And the answer is yes, we are still talking about mints. What other types of mints are there, Gem?
Well, you know what, I really like Treebore Soft Mints.
Treebore Soft Mints, they are nice.
There was a point where like I couldn't not have them in my car. They'd be in like the middle thing and just
I know what you mean. Yeah. They are delicious. They're just subtly squidgy. Everyone's a winner.
Except when they get really cold and then they're like the hardest, sharpest mint that has
ever
been.
They've got to be the right squidgy levels.
Yeah, I tell you what I don't like as well, warm chocolate.
Warm chocolate?
Some people love
interesting
it.
Interesting you say that. Today I melted my dairy milk on my laptop and I have to say, I ate it with a spoon out of the packet and it was delicious.
That might be where I'm going wrong.
Well, obviously you need to bring a spoon out, like if it's melted, then what are you going to do? You can't just wipe
you could,
your hands
like, you know,
it
like you get those
yogurts
and soups in a packet, you just squeeze them out, or like toothpaste. You could just do that.
Could do. And we see another Sven pick from LSE, and instantly Southampton
Radiant
return
Bam.
With the Ancient Apparition. A hero which is very strong against Wyvern. Obviously, the heal you can just stun because they're not moving, and also the heal is destroyed by the Ancient Apparition ulti, so I think that's a solid pick. It's also a great stun combo up with Tusk and Slardar, so that's a very good pick for them.
See,
and once again, I think we have to say LSE's draw is a little bit unconventional. We don't see Crystal Maiden that often, we don't see Sven that often, but based on the fact that they made their unconventional draft work last time,
Dire's ban.
I guess I'm not going to try and flame it this time.
Is Alk a big pick at the moment?
Alchemist is banned.
I know it's banned, but is it really being picked up that much that it's
the
first ban?
Everyone loves an Alk.
You see, I've not been picking up on the pros too much.
Except I've not been getting picked up because it's always banned.
Yeah.
I mean, you just get that bounty room at minute zero and the game's basically over.
I normally just ignore the ban and pick phases because you have, like, idiot casters reserve talking time. About bloody mints and crap like that. And it's, can't be bothered, you know?
Talking about mints? What kind of unprofessional production would the casters be talking about mints? He's a scam.
Oh, Moo makes a good point. Nerds. Aren't nerds delicious? Do you remember
they're
nerds?
They're mints, though, are they? They're sweets.
Yeah, but they're
Moo's
really
trying
nice.
To make us go off topic. Moo, we're trying to talk about mints here. Honestly.
We've got, like, four frosty heroes, and we've got, like, a blue hero in Sven. All of those are quite minty. Slardar would be a good tree bore, and then Shadow Fiend and Clockwork would have to be some sort of chili mint.
That sounds absolutely disgusting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we've got the final ban coming out now for Southampton. They're right. Probably, or well, they are Call looking it. To ban a mid hero. They've gone for the Lina, which is not a bad shout, I think. It's very good against BKB heroes, of which they have at least two. And LSE have gone for the Templar Assassin as their last pick. Interesting choice. Obviously, he has got a lot of flash farm potential with Agents, also does match up fairly well against Shadow Fiend. They don't have a huge amount of tick damage, mainly just the Agent Apparition Cold Feet.
Yeah.
So she's going to be fairly happy keeping her refraction charges up from that.
Plus, it's all big hits, Shadow Fiend. Oh, Spectre. Like I say, the Shadow Fiend and the AA and the Tusk are all like big hits that you can dodge with those refractions, but...
Yep, and there is the final pick, Spectre, one of my favourite heroes at the moment. Obviously combos beautifully with the Ancient Apparition in terms of the global potential of the hero. And we will see if they can get that farmed enough to win. Based on the amount of cosmetics that Alex has got for Templar Assassin, we can only assume that he really likes Templar Assassin.
I was going to say, I've not really looked at the curry as much. The fact upsets me a bit. We've got a Roshan for the Dire. We have a Ram.
We did have a Red Paw earlier, actually. Shout out to Ricardo, who really enjoys a
snuggle with his little cushy one.
We've got a little fact coming out from chat here. Thank you for Mootastic for this one. Jubula means to eat voraciously in Luganda. Luganda is the major language spoken in Uganda. Jubula for those. Wanting that again.
I'm currently worried that Moo's a compulsive liar and making you swear in other languages.
Potentially, but that is so out there that, I mean...
To showtime.
Surely that's got to be legit, right? If I have just sworn in Ugandan, then apologies to all our Ugandan viewers, of which I'm sure there are a lot. So, before minute zero, we are seeing a little bit of warding going on by Dire, and I'm going to quickly introduce the players. For Southampton, we've got UMR on Tusk. We've got Jin on Ancient Apparition. We've got Solo on Shadow Fiend. We've got UMR once again, UMR version 2 on Slaughter. And finally, carrying away Inspector, have Muzzard. Over to you, Dan. Take it away. Blow me away with the Radiant.
We have Crystal Maiden being played by the delightful 3K player. More skills in 3K. Templar Assassin being played by... Oh, God. Explicit. Is that Alex?
That is indeed Alex.
We've got Shiva Chi, playing Winter Wyvern. And we have, excuse me, Sven on off lane, being played by Yukime Graze? Clockwork, Road to Low Prio. I can only hope he gets there and is happy.
We can, he deserves it. Everyone go and report him. So this is a slightly unusual choice. I'm not sure what lanes LSE were expecting to come out from the Dire that they decided that putting Sven solo top was the one. Okay, he's not solo top actually, it looks like CM's going to be there as well, but CM actually in a little bit of trouble here, and I think that's a dead Crystal Maiden.
Oh, no, maybe not.
He is going to get clubbed down, and the damage that Chilling Touch does is crazy, but she's got away.
She's got a TP as well.
Another Ice Shard coming out in 10 seconds, but is that enough?
If the Shadow Fiend had come over, they could have had this, but she just needs to TP. Why is she not TPing?
She is on a serious mission.
Oh, she was too indecisive then.
Misses, though. I think she should still be TPing, even now. What would be amazing is if she got the courier kill, but no. And here we go. Here is the TP, and she is fine. And she has wasted a lot... I keep saying she, but we know that it's a guy playing.
she did well.
He slash she. We don't gender discriminate here at Game Britannia.
Wait, you're not going to mention all the other types of gender, just he and she. Oh, game triggered. Well, getting triggered.
I mean, they were just the most convenient two to mention at that time, by chance.
Other genders are available.
Other genders are available. If any of them would like to sponsor us, then I'm not sure we're up for that. But if you give us enough money, we're up for peddling anything.
You see, that worked out really well for CM. Tusk has zero experience at 2 minutes. AA has zero experience at 2 minutes.
Yeah, true that.
Both these heroes need six.
Apparently you've got an inverse? Oh my god, I really am losing it. An invisible Winter Wyvern who is going to potentially
steal a bit of experience,
make some plays, or indeed just steal some experience.
You know, there's one lane that's been going off and I've just ignored it this whole time while we've been running round and stuff. And mid is actually a bit of a battle. TA holding her own. 2-2 on the Shadow Fiend. 13-8.
Has been extremely dominating this mid lane. Crushed on Dragonlight against the Queen, a lane which I don't think he should have won. And he is absolutely miles ahead on TA against Shadowfiend. Obviously this is a lane which he should win, but still, this is a crushing lead.
Yep, I mean, Shadowfiend's slowly getting the souls up, which will help.
Huge amounts of harass going on to Ancient Apparition, and caught that right? Yeah, let's say you did.
It's Ancient Apparition, hate that hero.
That didn't see that kill, you blinked at a bad time. But what essentially happened was Winter Wyvern just harassed him down, stuck a Svenestun on top, and you're dead, son.
Oh, it's going off on top again. They're aggressive top.
And they have forced the Dire to bring all three of their heroes top. Just because this Sven and Wyvern are doing a lot of work, to be honest.
You know the drill.
Crystal Maiden is doing Crystal Maiden things. For those that don't know what Crystal Maiden things are, it involves Frostbite and creeps from the jungle. Action top, top action top, action
enough. Top.
Beep, 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 beep. The Mango comes out, and Sven gets another kill. Or actually, he doesn't. Wyvern gets another kill. Tusk gets another resist. And honestly, I don't think Sven wants to keep diving this.
I think that'll probably be quite a decent idea. The thing is, like, I don't know if Spectre was the right pick. They know that LSE like the aggressive game. They beat them in the long game before, but Spectre needs a farm, and he's just not getting it.
He does need the farm, but I think part of it is that Southampton were not expecting this lane.
No.
The Sven Wyvern aggressive lane. They probably expected to just be zoning out the clockwork, which they would have been able to do easily, but
you know,
I assume
what?
That it's Alex who's made the call for these lanes, and I think it's a good call when it's been a payoff.
Well, we're giving Spectre a hard time. He's currently on 18-2. It's you know, Sven's only on 13-3.
It's certainly not bad, but he'll be hoping to be more in the kind of 30-plus region right now at 5 minutes.
Yeah.
But, you know, it is what it is when you're dealing with a lane like this.
Exactly. It is aggressive.
Luckily, Spectre hasn't died, even though there has been a few deaths top for Southampton. Spectre has not been involved in those horrible deaths.
It's a nice hero to escape on, isn't it? Unless you've got the stuns, there's just no catching him as he trundles off through the woods.
You are quite right, Dan, as usual. Wow, that was a very nice thing of me to say to you.
It was. I'm taken aback.
Yeah, so am I! Almost as shocked as the first game when we were incredibly professional for a few minutes and I had to stop.
Oh, action mid, is he going to get it? There's a nice little...
Shadow Fiend does not look the happiest.
3k player, bringing
Crystal
out
Maiden stops jungling and decides that killing heroes might be a quicker road to winning the game than killing jungle creeps. Alex more than happy to enjoy some delicious experience from that. He's looking for the top rune. I think he would really enjoy a bouncy rune. Here it comes. There it is. Wow. I feel happy even though I had a 50% chance of getting that right. But with those odds, I was pretty much destined for greatness. I think Ancient Apparition is in trouble here. Wow.
He just got blown up. Sven is just wrecking.
They are playing so well in this lane. They clearly have a really good grasp of how far they can push the heroes.
Yep.
And they're doing a lot of work with them.
You know what? Bottom is being dominated by Clock as well. He's a level or two ahead, but he's just pushing Slardar out constantly. Slardar's currently on the march back home. he has just picked up his tranquils, which might actually help him out a bit.
Clockwork is just boots at all. Such an amazing hero to 1v1 against melee heroes. They can never dodge the rocket flare harass, and it's pretty much impossible for a melee hero to kill Clock, because the combination of cogs and battery assault means you are so hard to chase down. Shadowfiend in trouble mid once again. He's going to try and get the trade on the Crystal Maiden, but unable to. And Alex picks up another kill, and when thinking about heroes that you do not want to let snowball, TA is up there, right?
Oh yeah, it's one of my favourite snowballing heroes, actually, just because the games are so disgusting when he gets ahead. It is just two-shotting everyone.
The only thing we can say is that there's no ancient stacks yet for TA, so that is a plus, but at the same time... Oh no, we do actually have one stack for Shadowfiend in this game.
Crystal busy. Busy killing the forest.
Crystal Maiden is very busy, and she's already level 5, which is a pretty good effort. She's got a few levels up in the aura to help her team out. We have a rotation coming in on Alexer. He may be solo killing the Shadow Beam before the rotation can even pay off. And I'm not entirely sure he's going to die here. He may even turn around, and he has turned around.
This is exactly what we're talking about.
Talking of snowballing TAs.
Yeah, you get a little bit of farm in TA, and well...
Things happen. Scary things happen. And I can tell you that TA is one of Alex's favourite heroes, which he's told me about before.
There's mid tower.
I really wish I picked TA.
We're looking at hero levels. This AA has just wasted a TP for some reason. Oh, they were trying to plant a ward. That is not what they want. Wasting a TP while trying to plant a ward. Level 3. No boots.
You think Southampton are tilting a bit after losing to the weird Windrunner Clockwork offlane and Dragon Knight mid?
Maybe. I mean, it's also getting up, and that fatigues people. Maybe LSE are just dealing with the fact that we're, you know, like...
LSE students don't get to sleep anyway. They have to study all night.
Oh, kicking off mid. And Templar Assassin, you get a couple of levels in Refraction. Tower Diving doesn't mean a thing. There we go.
I want to say sad, but I don't think sad's a strong enough word. What have you got for me? Oxford Dictionary are tuning in.
Upset.
Upset? Well, that was better than sad, I'll give you that.
Because
okay. Tusk
the
is looking
tears,
to make a rotation top. Here he comes. Here's the snowball. Can Southampton get a kill?
Oh.
You would hear the answer is yes, but it's going to be a trade for the Spectre.
Spectre for Winter Wyvern is not what you're going for. The massive net worth of AA coming in at a strong 766. No boots yet.
Alex is going to casually take mid tower. And there is the blink. And this is a scary time to be alive if you're an ancient apparition.
Yeah, AA's got getting the stacks up, but in these levels, he needs level 6.
What I would like to see is for the. Radiant to maybe scout out some of these stacks, because they know that there's going to be stacks coming out for
the dead
dire.
Shadow Fiend again. One hit and two hit. I hate to say, but this is GG. If they don't deal with that TA soon, it is over.
Let's think about what they can do. I mean, Spectre has got the level 6. He can catch up very fast if you start getting a few kills with one. Shadowfiend is honestly just so far behind.
Yep.
That they've got no stacks for him is...
Look, one.
A really
two,
terrifying...
Three shots on Slider.
Oh, but I guess he is worth a disgusting amount of gold right now. But when you're fighting against a level 4 Tusk, you might not be that scared.
No, I mean, he's currently... I mean, oh no. The CM has more net worth than Spectre.
Dire's top tower is
getting
beat down.
What is really scary with the amount of gold that Desolator costs is that Alex is going to have Blink Desolator probably by 15 minutes, potentially even 14.
Yeah, there's currently a very scared Spectre hiding in the bottom.
Does not have a TP, and we've got 4 seconds until the clockwork.
I missed some
rocket.
More murders.
Don't
top.
Worry, here we go. Here comes the rocket. Down to 40.
Come on, camera, stay at the bottom. It doesn't want to stay. Here we go.
The dire best do something about their bottom.
Blink. How did she blink there? That was strange. You know where it is. Oh,
the courier's arrived. Can he TP? Just to add insult to injury, he wastes the 75 gold on the teleport scroll.
That was sad times.
A tough life, isn't it?
It is, but I'm enjoying this game.
Ben's
destroying Slide Arrow at the top.
Ben has decided to go for the Mask of Madness instead of Helm of Dominator. Any thoughts on that?
Manly thoughts.
Maybe he just thinks we're so
Tusk
far ahead.
Tusk does not want to be there. Tusk has just gone in. Sven's still got God Strength on. That was it.
Wow. It's 17-1 at the 12-minute mark. Indeed. That is a scary world to live in.
You say that Shadow Fiend can come back, but I don't know if you're coming back 1,800 net worth to 7,500 on the TA.
You're definitely not with the lack of stacks going on.
No.
I can only assume that what's happened is in the break, LSE realised that the first prize for this tournament is five times on the seven tomes, and they decided that they...
I thought we were giving them one. It's five.
Well, every player on the win team is going to receive an honor seven tome.
I genuinely thought they were going to be sharing that, like, you know.
Well, gambling is mistaken. And not only are the players going to be getting one each, but one lucky viewer is going to be getting one as well. It could be you. If you're listening right now, you're thinking, it's not going to be me, I never win these things, then maybe it will be. There is a link underneath the words, stream, and it says
underneath the words.
Underneath the stream. Come on, Gam, it's getting late.
I know, mate.
If
that's why it's so bad.
Exclamation uptime, then exclamation. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Exclamation, yes. Oh, the one thing I will say about the stream currently, we don't actually have that many people registered. You register that you are genuinely with a good chance of winning.
Yeah, it's something like a 10% chance of winning right now if you, How far is the Spectre from Radiance? 3 days, comes the answer from chat. And we said that the only way that Shadow Queen is going to come back in to this game is with stacks, and clearly, LSE think the same, because they have begun blocking the camps.
Well... Part of me thinks they're blocking the camps, part of me thinks they're just waiting to find more killers.
Meanwhile, Sven is making movements. Dire just couldn't save that bottom tower. PA is just casually farming towers, and I think my estimate of a 15-minute Decimator is going to be spot on. I would like to say, someone give me a raise.
Spectre? No? Shadow Friend?
The Dire best do something
raise
about that bottom tower.
Oh, wow.
We're here all night? Literally? No.
Yeah, it seems as though you may well be.
Right, I think I call it Shadow Friend is about to die again. One hit. Oh, three Rain hits this time. Death. Why is he running from the TP coming in? It's cancelled. That was a good shout.
And here is the Desolator. He's bought it at 14 minutes 30. By the time it gets to him, I reckon it's going to be exactly 15 minutes. And I'm going to be so impressed with myself that, I don't know, I would say eat a biscuit, but I already ate them. Dire's
top tower. You'll buy another overpriced Marks and Spencer's biscuit.
They're Waitrose, gang.
Waitrose.
Please.
Lost the top tower.
Hello.
I wanted it to be Spa, but...
We don't 53. Deal with Spa here in Georgia.
14.53.
Oh.
Pretty good.
I'm an amateur. Oh, and we may be seeing a kill here for the Dire, but no. Crystal Maiden kills the Spectre, things that you don't say very often.
Dire taking a fight that almost doubled their kills.
21-1.
Mm-hmm. This is probably the very definition of stomp. In fact,
I'll tell you what, there is one exciting possibility in this game, is that the score could end up being 3-2-2. I think it's a fair possibility that we get to the 3-2-2.
Nice. But news just in, Oxford has said, the Oxford Dictionary said they're going to put this video in its entirety under Ruffle Stomp. So.
Really? Oh dear, oh dear.
Video of the year for this one.
Crystal Maiden has decided, you know, I'm pretty rich, I'm going to start building an Aghanims. Because that's what Crystal Maidens do at 15 minutes.
Indeed.
Oh, someone is typing exclamation drop. What are they after? What do they want to drop? They want the beats to drop again. Rose is gone. Courtesy of the Radiant. Oh, and there's
big
the Crystal Maiden. Shadow Fiend, we say goodbye to you.
You know, it's not what
you want.
At this
point, Wyatt's just going in for solo kills.
I mean, like, your supports are just walking up to your mid hero.
And I think I
kills.
Expect the words GG to be written on the screen any second now. It's difficult to stay positive. He's typed in exclamation free money. That is optimistic to say the least.
I like to think our stream is printing money.
We do print money because there's so many viewers, so
much
ads.
Content. Don't talk to me about ads. We're not about the ads.
This is mayhem. Impressive. GG, there it is. Extremely dominating performance from LSE in game 3. Yeah, they got gradually better throughout the series. Congratulations to them. They will be proceeding to the quarterfinals of the tournament. Congratulations. My commiserations to Southampton, who put up a very good performance in game 1 and did Sven build a glimmer cape?
Did he?
No, he didn't, so I'm not satisfied.
No. The long and short is, I think Southampton can go home with at least some satisfaction that they took that first game. It was close and they played well, but LSE showed why they won the last LAN, really, keeping the dream alive for London.
Yep, I'm glad that we have still got a London, London team in, because as a London resident, I want some representation. And the only sad thing to say for LSE in that game is that they're probably going to have to kick Winter Wyvern for dying in that game.
I hear death is for Nuberinos, but
looks like
what have we got for the next game? UCL versus Nottingham, Thursday, 3rd of December, 7 p.m.
Who versus Nottingham, sorry?
UCL versus Nottingham. UCL, UCL.
DL, you're saying it so fast I can't hear it.
UCL.
UCL versus Nottingham this Thursday, which promises to be a very good game, with both of those teams in the top 3 of the Arrow tournament that's currently going on. That game will be cast by Maxis on Fire, so you may get a slightly more professional cast on Thursday. Although, will it be as entertaining? And probably
I'm not
yes.
even going to say it's going to be more professional, because like...
You don't think it's going to be more professional? We spent about 5 minutes talking about mints,
you might be able to
play the adverts.
I played the audio for the advert. The audio from an advert and
you
the advert.
Two sets of audio with one set of video. Oh, you tried your best, game, and that's all that matters. That's what we expect.
That's what I turn up for, you know?
So before you all leave, guys, got a few tiny requests. Some of the smallest requests you're going to hear all week.
What are they, Eric?
First one is click follow.
Whoa,
if you haven't already
small.
Clicked follow, then...
That's tiny.
What are you doing with your life, first of all? If you're already a follower, then don't click follow, because you will unfollow, and that's the last thing anyone here wants. Once you've done that,
never double click.
The next step, you've double clicked. What?
Never double click. Never.
Never double click.
Well, come on, hit me up with that second request.
The second request? I'm not sure. We've got so many options down there that I'm literally spoiled for choice.
What, those really nice looking buttons? I'd click them just to find
those
out what happened.
Those buttons look great. I don't know who is in charge of our graphic design, but they also deserve a raise.
In charge?
So next up, you've followed. You're doing great so far. Why not go on our Facebook? Why not go on our YouTube? Why not go on our Reddit, Google+, Twitter? And after you've done all that, go to our Honor 7 giveaway, because we would love to give you a handset. Someone's got to have it. If no one gets it, then I'm just going to keep it for myself.
Whoa.
Live the dream.
Okay.
And once you've done all that, you're probably thinking to yourself, I hear Rainbow 6 Siege comes out tomorrow. I need to go cop that. And while you're doing that, why not get an extra 3% off by going to g2a.com and using the code TGB for 3% off your purchase of Rainbow 6 Siege.
Smooth.
That was smooth, wasn't it? Oh, God, I'm good, Gant. Honestly.
Well.
Okay, guys, it's been great. Thank you so much for tuning in. I've enjoyed it. Any thoughts from you, Gant?
I've enjoyed it. Throat hurts like you would not imagine, but...
Well, you can have... Any final shout-outs you'd like to drop? Any sponsors to mention?
Huawei, you are my favourite. I love you. You are the light of my life, Huawei. Keep sending us
that friends. Is deep words coming out from Gan. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure you're here Thursday, 7 p.m. I'm sure you haven't got any other plans, because who's doing stuff at Thursday at 7 p.m? I'm sure not. So, see you there.
Peace.
Whether long-range weapon or suicide bomb, a wicked mind is a weapon of mass destruction.